Very good afternoon, students. Today we will continue with the lecture of financial derivatives. We have left a topic that is, we are discussing about the margin which is required by a clearing house or a broker to enter into a future contract. So we are on that topic until our last lecture. So continuing with the topic, we will start with this now. Now here we are on this slide. So we are discussing about the type of margins which is required by the broker at the time of entering into the future contract. So there the type of margins are the initial margin, maintenance margin, and the variation margin. So we have already discussed about the initial margin, that the original margin that must be deposited into account to establish the future contract is known as the initial margin. This is a very basic margin which is required to enter into a future contract. Next, to determine initial margin, exchange may consider the degree of risk. Now it is on the basis of degree of risk that how much risk is involved according to the value of the or the past movement in the price of the underlying asset. Now moving to the next. Now exchange has right to increase or decrease the quantum of marginal depending upon the change in future price. Now here, for example, if the margin is 5% first, now the exchange may increase it to 10% or may decline it to 3%. So it depends on the margin, or that how much margin requirement is there. Now moving to the next. Most of the future contract initial margin may be 5% or less of the underlying asset value. So in the most of the contract, the initial margin is always around 5%, or it may be less than 5%. Next, completion of all above all obligations with investor, future position, initial margin, and are returned to the trader. Now how it is returned to a trader? Now, because there are two parties, A and B, they have entered into the future contract. So let's take a 10 tons of iron ore. So here, if on the date of fulfillment of the settlement of the contract, now the values which has been invested will be adjusted with the value of the trader, or it will be returned to the trader at the time of the delivery. Now next is the maintenance margin. So maintenance margin is the minimum amount which must be retained kept with the margin firm. For example, if it has been said that normally out of 75% of the initial margin. So if, let's take an example that if the margin, now we can further explain it with the help of example. Let's take a text box here. Yes. For example, initial margin is 5,000. Now why this is 5,000? The value may be 1 lakh for the contract of 1 lakh. Now this is the initial margin which has to be made by the, which has to be maintained by the person or the trader, or it has to be deposited with the exchange while entering into the contract. Here, for the contract of 1 lakh, the 5% is, or the 5 lakh is the initial margin. Now, continuing with the maintenance margin, now out of this 5,000, the 75% is to be maintained every time in the account. Now what happened, that it has to be maintained every time in the account, that is the 75% out of that 75% of 5,000. So now what will be the 75% of 5,000 if we calculate? So that will come the maintenance margin. So let's calculate, and then we can further explain that what is the 5% of that is 75% of 5,000. So it came to 3,750. So this is known as the maintenance margin. So this is the amount of margin which has to be maintained every time in the account, because this is called the maintenance margin. Now we will further explain this. Now we have taken the example that for the contract of 5,000, the 5% is to be deposited as the initial margin with the trader, with the broker or the clearing house. Now here, this 5,000 will be retained with the this 5,000 will be retained with the broker, and on the time of settlement, this will be returned to the trader who have deposited this. Now, for example, normally about 75% of initial margin is known as the maintenance margin. So for the 5,000, if we take and continue with this example, so the 3750 will be the maintenance margin. Now, why the maintenance margin is maintained is the concept is there. Now there is a problem that if there was a profit on the future contract of rupees 1 lakh, then it will be added to this, or if there was a loss, then it will be deducted from this margin amount. So when the margin falls below 3750, the broker will call the trader to maintain the margin level at this point. So if the maintenance margin is 75%, then it has to be maintained by the trader every time in the bank account, because if it falls below that, then he may call for the further settlement of the margin or to bring that margin to minimum this amount. So this is the minimum amount which must be retained or kept with the margin account. So we cannot, in this example, it should not be group 375. Normally about 75 is the initial margin. Next, a future price movement again beside investors resulting in falling in margin account below the maintenance margin, broker will call. Demand for additional fund is called as the margin call. Now if the margin falls below 3750 in this case, and the broker calls for the maintenance of the margin, so that call will be known as the margin call, and it is the responsibility of the broker to maintain that margin. So if the maintenance margin is not maintained by the trader, then the broker or the clearing house is having the option to settle that trade before the expiry. So here the maintenance margin has to be maintained every time in the account. Now moving to the next, the example already we have taken here. Now next, for example, we will continue with this example. First I will clear this note. Yes. Now here, example, if the initial margin of future contract is 5,000 and maintenance margin is 3750, that is the 75%. Now here, exchange again, so the next day party has to sustain the loss of rupees 1,000, reducing the margin to 4,000, further decreased and sustained a loss of 5,000. Now balance of margin account is 3,500, which is below 3750. So here the broker will make a maintenance call and ask the trader to maintain the minimum initial margin, that is rupees 5,000 in the account. So this is the margin that has to be maintained in the account every time. And if it is fall below this, then he will make a call to maintain at this level. So here the main problem is that in case of this, if we are discussing about the future contracts here in the exchange, here the problem is that the investor will get profit and loss deducted from the margin account on the value of rupees, actual value of the contract. For example, in this case, the contract is of rupees 1 lakh. So the profit will be added accordingly. That is, if there was a profit of rupees 5,000, then it will be added to the margin account. And if there was a loss, then it will be directly deducted from the account and directly deducted from the initial margin amount. So here the margin has to be maintained each and every time by the broker, by the trader. Next, variation margin. Now first we have discussed about the initial margin, second we have discussed about the maintenance margin, and third is the variation margin. So additional amount which has to be deposited by the trader with the broker to bring balance of margin account to the initial margin level, that is known as the variation margin. For example, here the initial margin is 5,000, and in the margin account after sustaining the losses, the balance has become 3,500. Now the remaining 1,500 will be known as the variation margin that has to be deposited by the trader and has to maintain the margin at this level. So here in the as continuation with the above example, 1,500, that is 5,000 minus 3,500, difference of initial margin and balance margin account is known as the variation margin. Next, investor not pay initial margin immediately, broker may proceed to unilaterally close out the account by entering into offsetting the future contract. Next, if the trader fails to deposit this variation margin or to maintain the amount of the margin account to the initial margin account, then he may offset the account and close the future contract. So here, either if the trader fails to do it, either he will get the profit or he will get the loss. Although when there was offsetting of the account, then the clearing house and the broker has the right to close that account. Next, margin and marking to market, that is a daily settlement. So this is another important term in this. So we are here, that is the margin or the market to making marking to the market. So here it is a concept which states that we have to do the exchange and the broker has to do the daily settlements of the margin account. So this is known as the marking to the market, that is according to the market how the margin account is maintained. Now here, as we observed, that the initial margin, sometimes it is even less than 5% or less than 5%, which is very small amount considering the value of the future contract. Because for the contract of rupees 1 lakh, if we consider the margin, or we can take example of 10 lakh. For the 10 lakh contract, only the 50,000 is the margin. So here, the value of contract is very large as according to the margin, and margin amount is very small. Now, this smallness is reasonable because another safeguard built in the system known as daily settlement or marking to market. Now, as we have already discussed, the settlement will be done from this account and according to the profit and loss. If there was the loss, then the amount will be directly deducted from the margin account, and which will bring down the margin that is below the initial margin. So every time the trader has to maintain that margin with the broker or the clearing house. So here the amount is very small, but this is to safeguard the person because the losses will be already adjusted or settled on the day-to-day basis. Whereas if on the expiry of the contract, the person does not have to bear the loss in one instant, and this will be easy for the trader to settle the account. So here it is very small, and it will be done on the daily basis. That is known as the marking to the market. Now next, all the transactions are settled on a daily basis. The system of daily settlement in future market is called as the marking to market, as we have already clear that marking to market means when we maintain the margin account, that is either deduction or addition, on the daily basis according to the price fluctuation in the future contract. Next, trader realize the gains or losses on daily basis, understand this process of daily settlement. Now here, daily losses, they will be deducted, and daily profits will be added back to the margin account. Next, future contract is closed out and rewritten at a new price every day. So here, for example, you have entered a 3 month future. So it doesn't mean that it will be settled after 3 months only. So these are closed every day and rewritten at a new price in every beginning. So here, at the end of the day, EOD, the contract will be closed at the point. For example, if you have entered into the future, 3 month future, so let's take an example. If you have entered into the July wheat futures at the rate of 23,000 per ton. Now you have entered into this price. Now, 23,000 rupees per ton. Now you have maintained the margin here according to that. And what happened that, for example, today the price of the contract is rupees 22,500. Now here there was a lack of rupees 5,000. So this amount, now the price has been fallen by rupees 500 per ton. And if you have entered into 10 contracts, so the amount will be around 5,000. So this 5,000 will be deducted from your initial margin amount. And now that on next opening date, now next date when the this exchange will open or the market will open, on that time it will be rewritten at a new price at what it has been opened, and even on the end of the second day it will be again closed at a for a price at which it has been reached. So the daily fluctuation which are adjusted with the margin account is known as the marking to the market. Next. Now, how the settlement of this future contract has been done. So this is also known as the closing of a future position or the settlement of the contract. Now, it can be done in various ways. Now, the settlement of future contract can be done in various ways. The first and most popular way is the physical delivery. Now, physical delivery means when you deliver the goods physically to the another person, or you have delivered the warehouse receipt. For example, you have entered into a 10 contract of wheat that at a rate of 23,000 rupees per ton, and you have entered into a 10-figure contract. Now here, on the day of delivery, on the day of settlement, either you will do the physical delivery or the virtual delivery. Now, what is the delivery on paper? Because you have transferred the warehouse asset to the another party. Because generally, when the commodities are kept in the warehouse, then the warehouse receipt has been issued to the person on the behalf of which the trading is being done. Or if the person has bought that commodity on some future date, then also the warehouse receipts will be given. So warehouse receipts play a very important role in the physical delivery of the future contract or the settlement of the future position. Now here, first is physical delivery. Now what it means, liquidating future position by making or taking physical delivery of goods, assets, exchange provided alternatives to when, where, what will be delivered. Now here, if you take the delivery of goods as actual physical delivery of the goods, here you go to warehouse, present your warehouse slip and take the delivery of goods. Now next, choice of the party with the short position, the party is ready to deliver, it will send the notice of initiation to deliver the exchange. Now, deliver to exchange. Either second is that if the person has entered into short position. Now, short position means selling at higher and buying at lower. So, it is an inverse position. So, if you have already sold the commodity which you doesn't have, now to settle the short position, you will directly send the notice of initiation to deliver the commodity to the exchange. That is because you have already sold. You have to give the delivery. Whereas in the case of long position, in which you have already bought, it is another extreme end to the short position. Now, if you have entered into the long position, in the long position, the delivery or the commodity will be settled accordingly because you are optimistic and you have done the low buying and high selling. Now, here you have already bought and you are going to sell in the long position, then there is no issue. So that can be settled directly by the physical delivery or by the presenting the warehouse receipt. Whereas in this case, when we are closing the short position, in that case the delivery is to be directly sent to the exchange because the selling has been already done. So if you are not optimistic, then you will enter into short position. If you are optimistic, then you are entering into the long position. Next, price is settled with the possible adjustment of the quantity of the assets and chosen delivery location. Now here again there may be the variation in the quality. For example, you have entered into the future contract at the rate of 23,000 rupees per ton for the wheat. Now here on the time of delivery, you have found that there was a mixture of other commodities in that wheat commodity. So the mixture is 2%. So you will ask the broker or the exchange, you will complain to the exchange that there was a compromise with the quality. So it has been already written under the terms and conditions under the norms of the that is exchange. That is if the delivery of the commodities where the quality has not been as the person seems, or it is not a standardized. In that case, if the quality is not standardized, the exchange has the right to change the price accordingly. So here. The possible adjustment of quality of asset chosen and the delivery location will be done. For example, you will take the delivery. If you take a delivery directly from the warehouse, then the price will be different. Or if you want to take a delivery at some other premises. So if you want to take a delivery at some other premises, then there may be some other type of cost. That is your loading cost, that is unloading cost, that is your transportation cost. All the cost will be there. So then again the price will be settled accordingly. And if it is not taken at the warehouse, and if the delivery is taken from the warehouse directly, then it is very easy and it can be settled at that time only. Next is exchange selects the party with an outstanding long position to accept delivery. Now again, here the exchange selects the party with outstanding long position. Outstanding long position means when the person has not bought, but he has given the order to buy but has not ordered or not entered into the not buy the actual commodity. Now here what the exchange will do, he will select the party to whom the outstanding long position is of the delivery to be accepted. Next is the cash settlement of the delivery. First we have, and now what is the meaning of cash settlement? Cash settlement is when the settlement is done in the cash. Now here seizure is substitute of the physical delivery and does not require a physical delivery. Now, for example, you have entered into the future contract of wheat to sell that wheat. Now, on the day of settlement, you do not want that if you have entered into contract, that is the long position, that is to buy the wheat. Now here, as you do not want to take that delivery physically, you want that the amount that is the cash amount to be transferred to your account directly. So here, this the cash settlement is another substitute to the physical delivery and does not require a physical delivery. Only the cash should be transferred to your account, and no physical transactions of commodity from one place to another place has been done. Second, exchange notifies about the cash delivery as a settlement procedure. Now again, it is notified under the exchange that settlement in cash delivery can be done. Next, certain financial futures like stock indexes, treasury securities, euro, dollars, time deposit, municipal and municipal bonds, etc. So, of these commodities, the cash delivery can be done. Next, cash settlement contract expires. Exchange set its final settlement price equal to spot price of the underlying asset on that day. For example, you have entered into a 3-month future of any commodity, 3-month future of the iron. Now, let's take it, it may be the July future. Let's take a July iron July future 2020. Now, if you have entered into that position in that future contract, now here is the on the date of settlement. If you have not done the settlement, then what the exchange will do the final settlement and they will of the underlying asset by considering the spot price of that day of the underlying asset as the price of cash settlement. So if you are unable to do that, then exchange will do on your behalf, and the price that is equal to the spot price will be assumed as the price of that commodity. Next, prices of cash settlement contract is just like a price of delivery contract at their expiration period. So if at the period of expiry, as we will do the physical delivery, again in the same way the cash settlement of the contract of future has been done. Now next is the offsetting. This is the third thing to settle, that is the third point in the settlement of the contract. Now what is the meaning of offsetting? We will explain here. The liquidating the future position into effect an offset, that is markup for future transaction, or via reversing trade which reverses the existing open position. So if you have done such thing, then it means that you have offsetting the or liquidating the future position. Now next example is, for example, initial buyer who is a long position liquidates his position by selling and going short. Now what he has done, the person who has entered into the long contract, that is buying low and selling high, he to offset the position, what he has done, he himself goes into the short position. Now what he will do, how a person goes into short position, by selling the commodity what he is having. So what he has done one thing for another. He is having the one contract, that is a long contract, that is buy low and sell high, and before the expiry he has offset the contract by buying that commodity or entering into the short position, that is selling. Next, and an identical future contract, which is same, almost the identical to that contract, which means that same delivery month and same underlying asset. Now he has offset the one position with another position, although he is in two positions, one is a long position, another is a short position, but due to the identical future contracts, the net effect will be settled. Similarly, initial seller short goes for buying and long as identical future contract. So this is known as the offsetting, that is setting one future contract with the another future contract. Now, clearinghouse plays a significant role in facilitating settlement by offset. So the main is that the clearinghouse will be do this thing. Without the clearinghouse, it is not possible. Next, this method is relatively simple, require good liquidity in the market and initial user brokerage cost. So it will lower down the brokerage cost, and it is very simple, because if you have done one contract and another way you have offset that contract with entering into another identical contract, then first the cost will be brought down by entering into such contracts, because if you enter into such contract, you have not to make physical delivery or physical settlement. Next, for example, there are two parties, X and Y. X has the obligation to clearinghouse to accept 1000 bushels of cotton in September and to pay 180 per bushel. This is first thing, X party. Second, why has the obligation to the clearing house to deliver 10,000 bushels of cotton in September and receive 180 per bushel? Now both the parties can reverse off offsetting their position into the way where the buyer becomes seller and seller becomes the buyer. That is settling one contract with the another type of contract. That is setting long position with a short position and short position with the long position. So this is known as the offsetting. Now exchange of future for a physical. That is exchange of futures for a physical. That is liquidating the contract in the form of physical delivery is called the exchange of future. Exchange of future for exchange. So here if physical delivery is done, this is known as the exchange of future for future. Exchange of future for physical. Next is a party. So we are here. So a party holds a future contract like to liquidate his position. That is different from that the exchange offer. So this is another explanation. Now next example, a party may deliver may like to deliver the asset before the specified future period, or may deliver the asset at a different place, deliver outside the normal trading hours, etc. So this is known as the exchange of future for the physical. Generally, when we exchange the future contract for a physical, so it can, physical delivery, so it can be done before the expiry, or it can be done on the expiry. Next, EEP system, that is exchange of future for physical system, permits exchange of future position for cash position that meets both parties' preference. Parties must find willing to make this trade, make the trade. So it is again, it is a bilateral contract. As we all know, it cannot be unilaterally settled. So to settle, both the parties has to agree and offset the contract. So it is known as the EFP system. Next, now what is the difference between the future and the forward contract? This is another important topic. And with this, this topic of the futures will be over. And we will start with the new topic in the next lecture. So this is the last topic for today. So here, we will continue with this. For example, a private contract, what is the forward and future? So forward contract is the private contract between two parties, that is the bilateral contract. Next, the future contract, these are again the bilateral contract, but these can be traded on the organized exchanges. So this cannot be traded on the organized exchanges, this can be traded on the organized exchanges. Next, forward contracts are not standardized, they are customized, whereas future contracts are standardized, because as we have discussed the standardizers topic, that is standardization of the public transactions. So here we have to standardize our contract. Next, in the case of forward contract, normally there was one specified delivery date. On that date, it has to be delivered. Now here there is a range of delivery. Here the time has been given to deliver the commodities between the given dates. So here, this is here in the case of future contract, the range of delivery dates are there. Next, the forward contracts are settled at the end of maturity. No cash exchange prior to delivery date is done here. Daily settlement of profit and loss paid in cash, that we have already discussed, that is the margin requirements. Here, the margin requirements are not there. If there is a profit, if there was a loss, the forward contract, it will be settled on the forward date when the contract is settled. Whereas here, every day the contract is closed and it has been opened every day in the morning. So here, daily profit and loss to be paid in cash. If there is a profit, then it is paid in cash. If there was a loss, then it will be deducted from the margin account. Next. More than 90% of the forward contracts are settled by actual delivery of asset in the case of forward, whereas in the case of future, as we have already discussed, that not more than 5% of future contracts are settled by delivery, they are settled by the cash. Here, the no physical delivery is taken, only the adjustment has been done by the cash, but here the adjustment is done by the delivery of the asset. So this is another main difference. Next, delivery of final cash settlement take place, usually take place here. The amount is paid and the contract is settled here. Contract is normally closed out prior to the delivery. So these are the main difference between the future and the forward contract. So now we have over with this module, and we will start with the new module of financial derivatives in the next lecture. If you are having any queries, you can send the WhatsApp message or the mail, and we will respond to your query. Thank you for being with us.